Hello, this is week 10 of our music on the internet. So we'll start off in our usual way. So I'll start a new copy. Hello to you. Move your shoulders, 1, 2. Now stamp your feet and clap to the beat. Wave your hands up high. Point your fingers to the sky with a smile and a grin. Turn round and spin. Well done, everyone. Now our lesson has begun. Well done. The reason that I do that warm-up is, well, I wonder if you can think of a reason, actually. We do some actions. We do those actions in time with what? In time with the beat of the music. And I'm just trying to get you to focus so that you're ready to join in with the lesson and to be concentrating and focusing on what we're doing. So that's the reason that I do that warm-up. Right, well, I do that introduction, I should say. So the warm-up today, it's all about counting to 8. We're going to count to 8 4 times and clap at the same time. Are you ready? Off we go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done. So we were keeping the beat there while we were counting to 8 4 times. We're going to do that again, but not clap this time. We're just going to count to 8. Are you ready? We're doing it 4 times. Ready and go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done. Don't get faster as you're counting. Try and keep nice and steady. If at any point I'm going too fast and you want to just go over again what I've done, then just pause the video and you can always go back again. Right, the next part of this exercise. So we're going to choose a number from 1 to 8 and that number we're going to clap on. So I'm going to choose a number for you. We're going to clap. We're going to choose the number 2. So only clap on 2. We're counting to 8 4 times though. Are you ready? Off we go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done. Did you all manage to count on clap on 2? We're going to choose a different number now. We are going to choose number 6. So only clap on 6. All of the others we're just counting. Remember, we're going 1 to 8 4 times, clapping on 6. Ready and go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Which number shall we do now? Shall we do number 4? Okay, only clap on 4. Ready? Off we go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done. Right, we're going to make it a little bit more difficult this time and we're going to choose 2 numbers. And let's choose number 4 and number 6. So we're going to clap on 4, clap on 6, but only count all of the others. 1 to 8, 4 times. Are you ready? 4 and 6 to clap. Off we go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done. Shall we choose another two numbers? Let's choose number two and let's choose number five. Two and five. Ready? Off we go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done. Right. I would like you now to choose two numbers of your own. So this is everybody in the class. Choose the same two numbers. So if you need a little bit more time, pause the video. So choose two numbers. Everybody's going to clap those two numbers. I'm not going to clap them. I'm just going to count from 1 to 8 four times. Are you ready? Off we go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done. I want you to choose two different numbers now in your class. So pause the video. Okay, so have you chosen your two numbers? It might be that you're doing this at home and you can choose two numbers of your own. So, are we ready? Off we go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8. Well done. Right, the last part. I want all of you to choose a different number, not the same two numbers. Everybody choose one number, but don't tell your friend what that number is. You don't choose one that your friend has chosen. Everybody choose something different. Now, whatever number you've chosen, you keep that number, and that's the one you're clapping on. So it could be that a lot of you are clapping on one. It might be only two of you are clapping on number two. It might be that a few more are on number three. So you're making your own class rhythm now, but you've got to stick to your number. Are you ready? Off we go now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Did that rhythm sound interesting? Did you manage to keep to your rhythm? Did you manage to keep to your number? The reason that I did that game is so that you can all feel the beat and keep together in time with the beat. You internalise the beat because you've got to do something on some of them and not something on the others. You're resting on the others. So it's all to do with keeping the beat. Okay. Okay, so what I've done now is I've shared a screen with you, and it is the screen of the words of a song by Bob Marley. We listened to this last week. And the song is called Three Little Birds. So remember, if you join in, the highlighted words are the ones that are being sung at the point, at that point. So we're going to sing through this. This is in reggae style. Reggae is a style that was introduced by the Jamaican population in America. And this was very popular in the 70s and 80s. Right, here we go. So join in if you can.
Every little thing gonna be alright. up this morning, smiled with the rising sun. Three little birds pitched by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. Singing, don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing gonna be alright. Singing, don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing gonna be alright. Rise up this morning, with the rising sun, three little birds pitched by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying,
this is my message to you.
Enjoy that. Is that the kind of music that you would normally listen to, or is it a different style of music to what you're that you normally listen to? So remember, that style is called reggae. It has a particular rhythm to it. Right, we're going to come back to that song in a bit. I'm just going to stop sharing the screen. Okay, so I'm sharing a different screen with you now, and this is of our stave. So what we're going to do is we're going to remind ourselves of how we actually read our music. So on our stave, our five lines and four spaces, we have a, what's this at the very, very beginning? It's like a capital letter at the beginning of the sentence. That is a treble clef. Well done. So I'm just going to take this note off the stave a minute. Now, if the blob of the note is on a line, we find out the letter name of the line by remembering the rhyme. And the rhyme is, can you remember? I'll tell you. Every good boy does football. So E for every, G for good, B for boy, D for does, F for football. So if this blob from this note is on the first line, it's E for every. If it's on the second line, it's G for good. Third line, B for boy. Fourth line, D for does. Fifth line, F for football. Well done. If it's on a line, it's the rhyme. Every good boy does football. Let me take this note away again. If the blob of the note comes in a space, it spells face. F A-C-E. So if the blob is in the first space, it is F, the first letter of face. If it's in the second space, it's A, the second letter of the word face, F-A. If it's in the third space, it is C, F-A-C, the third letter of face. And then finally, if it's in the fourth space, it's E, fourth letter of face. So let's just have a little test. If I put it on the second line, what's the letter name? So remember, if it's on the line, it's the rhyme. The rhyme is, say the rhyme, every good boy does football. Well done. E for every, G for good, B for boy, D for does, F for football. So what's that letter there? G, G for good. I'm going to put it in a different place now. If it's in a space, it spells face. And here we've got it, it's the third space up. So it's the third letter of face. So that is a C. Well done. Okay, so that's just reminded you how the stave works. Right. Right, I've come back now to our song and I'm just going to see if I can find the music. Here we go. So this is, it's the Glockenspiel. It doesn't matter, it could be a violin, it could be a piano, it could be anything. So let's have a look and remind ourselves of these notes in here. So that is on the second line. I hope you can see this. So that's on the second line, so that is a G. Then the next note is an A. It's in the second space. So that one there is a G. Well done. Then we've got a rest and then a whole bar rest. So what are these notes here? Let's say them. G, A, G. Well done. What about this line here? If you notice, all of the blobs are in the second space. They're not like the line up above. They're all the stave up above. They're on the second stave. They're all in the same space. So they are all A's. So we've got A, A, A. Well done. And then we finish here with G, A, G. Well done. Right, so how we did it this last week, we had a different percussive sound for each of those notes. So it could be that you've got a tap and a shake. So if I was to tap the table and shake, so tap for G, shake for A. Do you want to get some percussion instruments? Just pause the video to do that. So we've got a tap for G, shake for A. Okay, shall we have a go at doing that? Are you ready? We're going to read the first line. Off we go now. Tap, shake, tap, rest. One, two, three, go. Tap, shake, tap, rest. One, two, three, stop. On the second line, remember that we've got three A's now, so we could do three shakes. One, two, three. And then we carry, let's do that bit again. Ready and go now. One, two, three, rest. One, two, three, four. Then it goes back to tap, shake, tap. Okay, let's go through both lines. Are you ready? Off we go now. One, two, three, rest, 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 rest. G, A, G, rest, 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 rest. A, rest, 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 rest. G, A, G, rest, 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 rest. Okay, so let's see if we can get the music going. And then I will put this onto the sheet music quite quickly and we'll see if we can follow this music. So you're reading notes. Let's see if I can do this. Put this back to the beginning. Here we go. Oh, let me just put the words back to the beginning. Let's go back to the very beginning. Okay, there's a bit of an introduction at the beginning before we start, so that'll give us a bit of time. To change this to a different picture, a different set of music. Now, have you noticed the notes are different? So you've got a note that's in the third space up. So remember, if it's in a space, it spells face. So this is the third space up, so it must be an F-A-C. It's a C. So we've got C there, and then we go jump down to the second space up. So that is F A. So we've got C A. What's that one? C. Well done. And then we've got lots of rests. This is the same as the first bar. C A C. Lots of rests. C A C. Lots of rests. C, A, C, lots of rests. Now, what I want you to do is, in the last one, we had G, A, G, didn't we? So for the A, I had a tambourine. I'm gonna keep the tambourine for the A. So I want to have a different sound for C. I'm going to use a drum this time. So you can't see that really. No, you won't be able to see that. But you're just going to have to believe that I've got a drum. Oh, I could do that, couldn't I? And then that on the A, so I could go C, A, C. All right, do you get that? So I don't know, you choose a different sound for your C's and your A's, all right? So I'm going to go back to the song again. And we're going to play through it again, this time using two different sounds, but reading as if it's C-A-C. There's an introduction.
This morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds pitch by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying,
this is my message to you.
So you are, I've been learning over the last few weeks all about reading different notes on a stave. So that's getting really quite good. I'm going to share with you now another screen, and we're just going to learn another piece of music, another tune called Chilled, but it's just the rhythm that you're going to be reading now and not anything to do with the notes. Okay, so this piece of music is called Chilled. There's quite a lot of notes here, aren't there? So let's go through it. So if I just maximize that screen, then you'll be able to see everything, hopefully, so that you can see everything at the beginning. No, that's not very good, is it? Right, let me put that back up again. There we go. So at the beginning of each stave, we have got our treble clef. And then that's followed by our time signature. And that's the magic number of this piece of music. So the top number is the number that we're interested in. So the top number is number four. Then we've got all of these rhythms. So we've got, I'll go through the first line. It goes ti 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 ta ta, ti 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 ta ta, ta. That last note there is a semibreve. It's four counts long. Okay, I'm going to go on the second line. Join in with me if you want. Ready? Go. Ti 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 ta ta, ti 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 ta ta, ti 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 ta ta. Next line, ta. Stop. Okay, the next one here, this is a minim, this is a two count note. Let's start from this minim. Are you ready? Off we go. Ta ta, ti ti ta ta, ti ti ta ta, ti ti ta ta, ti ti ta ta ta, ti ti ta ta. Well done if you've kept up. Goes on to a second page. Let's see if I can get it. Here we go. Ready and go now. Ti ti ta ta, ti ti ta ta, ti ti ta ta ta, ti 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 ta ta, ti 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 ta ta, ta. Stop. Remember, that's a semibreve, that's four counts long. Right, carry on. Ready and go now. Ti 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 ta ta, ti 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 ta ta, ti 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 ta ta, ta 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 ta. And then it's finished. Okay, so get your percussion instruments. And if I just minimize that, in fact, do I have to? Maybe not. Okay, I'm going to start the music. It has an... Did you manage to keep up with that with your percussion instruments? Let's just have one more go at doing that before we finish our lesson. So you're reading the rhythms and playing this with your... Thank you. done. Okay, so today we have read a lot of rhythms. You've listened to some reggae music and we've reviewed again how we actually read our notes on a stave. So very well done. And all that remains is for me to say goodbye.